Hello everyone, now today we are here to do an experiment. Aim of this experiment is performing the following reaction and classifying them as physical or chemical changes. First reaction, iron nail and copper sulfate solution in water, burning of magnesium ribbon in air. Third one is action of dilute sulfuric acid on zinc metal. Fourth, heating of lead nitrate. And last, reaction between the sodium sulfate solution and barium chloride solution. Material required to do this activity are copper sulfate solution, dilute sulfuric acid, sodium sulfate, lead nitrate, barium chloride, magnesium ribbon, zinc granules, iron nails, one tong, test tube holder, candle, beakers, matchstick, spatula, test tubes. Let's start the first part of our activity, in which we will do the reaction between the copper sulfate and iron nails. Now, to do this, I am adding small amount of copper sulfate solution in a test tube. Now, observe the color of the copper sulfate. It is bluish in color. Now, I will dip two iron nails on which I have tied thread. I am dipping the iron nails in the copper sulfate solution. I will mix it and leave this setup for 5 minutes undisturbed. Test tube after 5 minutes. See that the color of the copper sulfate solution, which was initially bluish, it has changed into the greenish blue color, and this greenish blue color represents the iron sulfate solution. Now, when I will remove this iron nail from the test tube, you can see that there is a brownish coating on the iron nail, and this brownish coating is of the copper. So which type of the reaction it is? It is a displacement reaction, in which because of the more reactivity of the iron, it has displaced the copper from its sulfate solution. As you can see in the reactivity series, that iron lies above the copper, so it means that iron is more reactive than copper and it displaces the copper from its salt solution. Now let's do the second part of the activity. Let's do the second part of activity, in which we will burn the magnesium ribbon with the help of the candle in the presence of air. Observe the color of the magnesium ribbon. It is shiny in appearance, grayish in color. Now we will burn it with the help of the candle. Now in the candle flame, I will burn the magnesium ribbon. Now see, it is burning with the dazzling white flame. See that after burning, the magnesium ribbon has changed into the white ashes. This white ashes represents the magnesium oxide. Now let's do the third part of our activity, in which we will do the reaction between the zinc and sulfuric acid. To do that, I will take a test tube in which I am adding small granules of the zinc. Now, in this test tube, I am adding small amount of sulfuric acid. Now observe the test tube very carefully. Now there will be the reaction between the zinc and sulfuric acid, and when the reaction start, small bubbles arise from the test tube. That bubbles represents the hydrogen gas, and this solution will turn into the zinc sulfate solution. Now you can see that in the test tube the reaction between the zinc and sulfuric acid is occurring, due to which the bubbles are rising. This is a colorless, odorless gas which represents the hydrogen gas. To speed up this reaction, we can heat this test tube so that we can clearly listen the pop sound of the gas which is coming, because by heating the reaction will be fast, more amount of the hydrogen will be released, and it will be easy to show you the pop sound of hydrogen gas. Now, by holding the test tube with the test tube holder, I am heating this mixture. You can see that from the test tube the bubbles are arising with more speed. It means more amount of the hydrogen is releasing. Now if I will take the burning candle near to the mouth of the test tube, have you heard the pop sound? This pop sound represents that the gas which is evolving is a hydrogen gas. So what we have concluded, that by the reaction between the zinc and sulfuric acid, zinc sulfate solution is formed, and when gas is released, that gas is hydrogen gas. Let's do the next part of our activity, in which we will heat the lead nitrate. Now to heat it, I am adding small amount of the lead nitrate in a test tube. Observe its color. It is white in color. Now I will hold this test tube with the help of a test tube holder. Now I will burn a candle. Now let's heat this lead-nitrate crystals. Initial color of the lead-nitrate is white. Now notice that a light brown color gas is coming from the test tube. This brown color gas represents the nitrogen dioxide. The reaction that is occurring here, is the lead nitrate is decomposed into three things. One is the lead oxide that will be remain in the test tube, which have the yellowish brownish color. It will be also decomposed into the nitrogen dioxide. The gas that is brownish in color, which is coming from the test tube. One more gas is coming, that is oxygen. So by the decomposition of the lead nitrate, lead oxide, nitrogen dioxide and oxygen will be formed. Now see that the crystal at the bottom of the test tube is yellow in appearance. This yellow between the sodium sulfate solution and barium chloride solution. For this I am taking almost equal amount of the sodium sulfate and barium chloride in two beakers. In first beaker I have added sodium sulfate, in the second beaker I have added barium chloride. Now I will add water in both the beakers to make the solution of it. Now I will stir it. Now to do the reaction between sodium sulfate and barium chloride, I will mix these solution in separate beaker. First of all, I am adding sodium sulfate in it and then I am adding barium chloride solution in it. Now we will leave this setup for 2 to 3 minutes undisturbed and then we will see what happens after the reaction between the sodium sulfate solution and barium chloride solution. Let's observe the beaker where there is a mixture of sodium sulfate and barium chloride after 5 minutes. Due to the reaction, you can see that there is an insoluble white color precipitate at the base of the beaker and a clear liquid above it. The insoluble white precipitates are for the barium sulfate and the clear liquid above it is for the sodium chloride. So the reaction that is taking place here, the reactants were barium chloride and sodium sulfate. When they react, the new products formed, that is barium sulfate and sodium chloride. Barium sulfate is an insoluble white color substance that will be settled down at the base of the beaker, and sodium chloride is a transparent liquid that remain above the barium sulfate. This type of the reaction is a double displacement reaction. Watching this video, I hope all the reactions and the changes occurring in that reactions are clear to you and you have enjoyed it. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.